nudity, coarse language, and explicit discussions on sexuality. Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm aching for you, baby. I can't pretend I'm not. I need to see you naked in your body and your thought. I got you like a habit, and I'll never get enough. There ain't no cure. There ain't no cure. There ain't no cure for love.
The term chicken is an American slang word for a teenager who engages in indiscriminate sexual practices for money, which is what I was doing at the time. The first agent of social change is information, and I'm trying to change people's perception of sex work, sex workers, and just to get the information out that there are so many different kinds of people who've done this work. The term chicken is an American slang word for a teenager who engages in indiscriminate sexual practices for money, which is what I was doing at the time. Ironically, the man who brought me into the business was actually the manager of a restaurant called Hollywood Fried Chicken. Nobody forced me into prostitution, and I wouldn't say I fell. I was in very desperate circumstances. I was in Hollywood. I was 17 years old. I was without any kind of supervision. And I was there to go to college. I didn't have any money. The women who hired me to service them, my clients, when I was a chicken, they all had one thing in common: money. They all had money. They were all older than me. They all seemed to have threads of loneliness in them. About half the women who hired me paid me just to talk to me. They didn't even really want sex. They just wanted to talk to a naked 17-year-old boy and have him be nice to him and say how pretty they were. And the other half wanted very specific, almost fetishistic activities.
Welcome to Sex Worker Literati Night here at the original Barnes & Nobles.
It's unusual in the sex workers movement to encounter a heterosexual male prostitute. We have a lot of misconceptions about male sex workers, and there are a lot of assumptions that we're making, even in the sex industry itself.
I've thought a lot about why there are so few heterosexual male prostitutes, gigolos, if you will. First of all, it's a safety issue. Men are bigger than women, and there's a lot of fear involved. Secondly, I think in our culture, women are discouraged from the time before they're born from expressing themselves sexually and fulfilling themselves sexually. I know that there are so many women, because I've gotten emails from them, who would love, who fantasize about hiring a man, but they don't quite know where to find one. They don't feel safe about it. And it's illegal, so it's a very difficult proposition.
Every week, I swear to you, I get these emails from these guys.
I like sex. I like money. How do I get started being a gigolo and having sex with beautiful women and making a lot of money at it?
Every week I get these emails. And I always email back, please read my book before you start doing this stuff.
as a man, as a really a man-child boy, really, who was servicing women, it wasn't all horrible and it wasn't all great. Some of it was wonderful and some of it was absolutely debilitating work that scarred me for the rest of my life. I was offered many, many times the opportunity to work with men. In fact, the agency I worked for begged me to. But for me personally, having just been sexually abused by a man, the thought of it was just, oh, I couldn't even bring my mind to consider the possibility. What got me out of the life, in the business, I was hired by this guy to physically and verbally abuse him, and he was kind of insinuating we were going to have some kind of sexual encounter, we're going to get sexy with each other, and I'm like, that's not going to happen. And he asked me to come over, and I put my head, he had this corset on, it was kind of like cross-dressing, he put my head like on his chest, and I felt this tugging, this weird tugging on my head, and I looked up and he had my hair in his mouth and he was sucking on it. Now, as I say this now, it doesn't seem like that weird a thing. I mean, there's a lot more weird things than that, but at the time, I just snapped. And I destroy this man's apartment and I beat him. It's one of the things I'm very ashamed of in my life. And for a moment, I thought I had killed him. I really did. And I believe it was my subconscious's way of getting me out of that life, because once I did that, I could never work for these people again. We are currently in San Francisco's colorful Tenderloin District. We in America tend to think that the problem of kids being used in the sex business is something that goes on in New Delhi, and it goes on in Brazil, and it goes on in Bangkok. But it goes on right here in America, right on this block. In one of these hotels, it's going on right now. I feel like we have to focus our attention on this problem before it'll go away. There are many people who do sex work. They come to it as an adult, making informed decisions. Yeah, this is how I want to make my living. Well, that's different than being 17, homeless, raped, and getting into the business then. So I don't want to make this seem like there aren't people who do sex work who choose it as a career. It can be a great career for some people. It just wasn't for me. And when I got out of the business, I basically, I never looked back.